like you know how this goes.
Introduction to Visual Scripting Notes. Hello, creators. Welcome to Effect House. If you've ever dreamed of creating fun and interactive TikTok effects, but unsure where to start, especially with no coding background, you're in the right place. In this course, we'll equip you with visual scripting skills to transform your innovative ideas into interactive TikTok realities. No coding experience? No problem. You don't need any. So what exactly is visual scripting? Visual scripting is storytelling through nodes, not words. It's programming through nodes, not text. You can use nodes to construct your narrative piece by piece, like assembling a puzzle. As nodes connect, they interact, share data, and animate your digital vision. The ability to use visual scripting for your effects is essential for creating interactive TikTok effects. Over 6 videos, we'll guide you from basics to mastery in visual scripting. Get ready to evolve from a thinker to a builder. Let's get started. Understanding visual scripting nodes. First up, let's dive into the core of your visual scripts, nodes. Think of nodes as the fundamental components shaping the grand design of your digital projects, each tasked with a specific function from altering colors to initiating sounds. In the node library, nodes are meticulously sorted into 18 distinct categories, including a custom category for your creations, alongside 17 others filled with predefined nodes by our engineers. Looking for face-related nodes? Simply navigate to the head and face category. You'll find many nodes to use. Each node is clearly named to reflect its function and color-coded by category for easy identification. Let's have a look at some fun nodes. Beats Detection Audio captures real-time music beats, ideal for crafting rhythm-driven effects. Here is another fun node. Facial Movement Detection interprets facial movements for dynamic, expression-based effects. In this case, when the camera detects mouth open, it will remove your hair. Random node can produce a random number within a specified range. Try using it to change an object's color at runtime. Now it's your turn to dive deeper. Happy exploring! Adding nodes to your script. Adding nodes is simple. Right-click in the visual scripting editor, choose from the library, or search by their name, and copy and paste as needed. In addition to standard nodes, digital elements such as objects, assets, or object properties can be converted into nodes as well. For objects and assets, drag them directly from the left side panel into the visual scripting editor to transform them into nodes. To convert properties, visit the inspector panel. Click the circular button next to each property name, and you can see it appearing in your editor canvas right away. Turning these elements into nodes allows real-time control as needed. We'll dive deeper into this in future modules. Anatomy of a node. Let's zoom into a node structure. Focus on the ports, the green triangles and the gray circles. There are two types of ports: control ports, which are green triangles that dictate the node's operation, steering the workflow. On the other hand, data ports, which are the gray circles, are conduits for data transfer. You can check out each port's function by clicking the info button on the right corner of each node. Nodes may possess either control ports, data ports, or a combination of both. Connecting nodes. Here's where the real fun begins. Connecting nodes. It's like linking a route on a map that guides your interactive effect ideas through its journey. Connect them, and you've got a sequence of operations from left to right. The left node runs first, followed by the right node. The order of execution can be critical for successful implementation. Try to write down the steps before assembling the nodes. Some nodes, like start, update, video record, and screen tap, work as the first node to start the whole operation, while others can only be used in the middle of the flow. Deleting nodes. Removing nodes or links between them is as simple as selecting and hitting delete. For batch deletions, press the shift key, click, and then swipe through the connections. Tour of the Visual Scripting Editor. Now let's take a tour of our command center, the Visual Scripting Editor. Here, you can create and manage your visual scripting graphs. It includes the visual scripting toolbar and the dotted space for graph building. The dotted space is like a canvas for your creativity, where all your nodes live. To zoom in and out of the dotted space, pinch or scroll on your trackpad or mouse. To navigate around the dotted space on a Mac, click with two fingers and then drag to move across the canvas. If you're using Windows, right-click to do the same thing. The visual scripting toolbar contains some handy buttons that help you navigate the space and manage nodes and variables. Key features include My Items for organizing variables and subgraphs, Reset functions to maintain workspace consistency, Minimap for an overview of scripts, Search bar for quick node access, Details for node perimeter adjustments, Comment for clear communication, Add node for easy node insertion, and dock and undock for flexible workspace management. Additionally, if you hover over the icons, you can see what each icon means. Congrats! You've taken your first step into the vast universe of visual scripting with EffectHouse. Before we wrap up, let's test your newfound knowledge. Can you distinguish between the green triangles and the gray circle ports on a node? Share your answers in the comments below. Remember, this is just the beginning for our next sessions, where we'll dive into subgraphs, interactions, variables, and beyond. Transform your ideas into interactive masterpieces with us. Enjoyed today's lesson? Don't forget to subscribe, like, and join our community of creative pioneers. Your journey from imagination to realization starts now.